Mr. George Lucas.
I heard you say on 60 Minutes with Barbara Walters, a detour.
Well, Star Wars was a detour. It started out as one movie, and it's ended up being 30 years of work. So, you know, in that way, I'm glad to be finished, because it's, you know, as feature films, it's you know, 3 years to do each one of them, and it's a lot of commitment, a lot of work, a lot of time, a lot of money. So now we're sort of moving into television, and we're going to do some animated shows, and we might do a live-action show, but it'll be television, not feature films. It'll be much quicker, much faster, and because I was telling one story over six films. So, you know, it's a long time to tell one story.
I understand that there was a passion for being a racing driver back in the early days.
Well, when I was in high school, I loved racing cars, and I wanted to be a mechanic and build cars. And then I was in a pretty horrific car accident. Meditation in a hospital sort of changed my mind about all that. And then I went back to school, and I discovered film. And life sends you on different paths, and you sort of, when you get an opportunity, you have to take it and explore it, and, you know, and it leads you in very funny places, places you'd never expect to be.
Going way back to the days of American Graffiti. And
that started out as a very, very low budget movie. You know, it was made for less than $1 million on a very short schedule. Man, it was crazy, but then, you know, it turned into be an extremely successful movie.
Do you know it at the time?
No. Now, you have no idea when you're making a movie whether it's going to be successful or not. You gauge a movie by what you like. So I think this works, I like this, therefore I'm going to put it in the movie. And you just hope that somebody else does.
And there's a lot of pressure, a lot of decisions to be made. And like even with the early Star Wars, it was a difficult film to make, wasn't it?
Well, I was very fortunate. I found somebody, a studio executive, Alan Ladd Jr., who believed in me. He didn't understand the script very much, but he did say, "You're a talented guy, and I think you can make this movie." I made it in England, so I was a long way from Hollywood when I did it, so they really couldn't, you know, come and see what I was doing, and that helped. And then when I finished it, I came up here to San Francisco, and that's a long way from where they are, too. So basically, I managed to keep them out of my hair most of the time. But in the first time, it was just that unknown that was a big factor of confusion for everybody.
Yeah, we are dealing with darker themes in the third one.
It's not that much different than the other ones, but it's got some rather intense images of Anakin being on fire, and a few more people get their arms and legs cut off than normal, yes. But we always do a lot of that. But ultimately, it's very emotionally dark, which is, you know, it's about how a good person turns into a bad person, it's about how a democracy turns into a dictatorship, and we get to episode 4. You're great in this one because you multiply. You're everywhere. The clones have taken over. Boba Fett rules the world.
Very good, sir. Oh, by the way, I think you'll be needing this.
There's a lot of expectation with the last one, so does that make you nervous?
I've sort of given up on that part of it because the expectations get so high that it's, you know, it's very difficult to meet them, and my job is really not to meet everybody's expectations. My job is to do the best job I can making the movie and make it be as true to itself that it can be. So, you know, some people are always disappointed. Mm. Some people love them. Some people hate them. Mm. You know, there's always this mix of reactions to the movies, and it's always been that way ever since the very beginning.
And in terms of the future, where do you think we're going?
Well, it's when you're doing science fiction films, you need to push the medium forward in order to be able to do fantastic things like fly around in space or have aliens that talk. So I pushed the medium forward for that, and then sort of moved into the fact that the whole process was done in one medium, digital, rather than half film, half digital. And this is basically the way cinema is going to be from now on. I think it's a great advance in the medium of cinema because it makes it much easier to work. The quality is better than what you'd find on film, and at the same time, cuts down your expenses. And since I have to finance my own movies, I'm very cost conscious because I don't have a lot of money to throw around like the studios do.
Well, thank you very much, George, for your time. And thank you also for cloning me. There's only been me and a sheep called Dolly, I think.